This series has been specially designed for recorded use. Full details are in the notes for teachers. A starting direction. Changing the direction is turning. In this case, a small turn anti-clockwise. A larger turn clockwise. This time, we've gone past the starting direction to make an even larger turn, anti-clockwise. Again, anti-clockwise. The amount of turn can be as large as we like. Passing the starting direction gives a possible measure of turn. What part of a turn is this? And this? Straight line, angle. Quarter turns and squares. Sixth turns and equilateral triangles. For angles smaller than one revolution, we can use parts of a turn. Two parts, four, twelve parts, seventy-two parts, each one a 72nd of a revolution. And, of course, the familiar division of a revolution into 360 equal parts, each of which is the convenient unit we know as 1 degree. Let's use degrees to measure this angle. Notice that we've decided to measure anti-clockwise, starting here. degrees. Let's abbreviate that. But 69 degrees isn't the only angle that can be associated with this sector. In each case, we started and finished in the same two directions. and so on. Let's look at this another way. Again, we've used the same starting and stopping directions. It's probably more convenient to think of this set of angles as associated with the clockwise measure of this sector. To describe the motion of the car, we need a direction, a starting point, and a scale. In the opposite direction, but how do we now describe this displacement? Here's one method. Distance. Angle. Or we could have measured the angle clockwise. But let's look at the previous example again. Central displacements are along the initial line. Sideways displacements are at right angles to the initial line. In this way, every displacement can be described by two distances, often called projections. the initial line, the unit circle, graph paper. In this sequence, we shall describe each angle by a particular projection of this line of unit length. A sideways projection. The sine of the angle 40 degrees is 0.64. Here, a larger angle will have a larger sine. For a general angle, theta, sine theta is always the sideways displacement. The usual abbreviation, sine theta. The initial line, the unit circle, graph paper. In this sequence, we shall describe each angle by a particular projection of this line of unit length. A central projection. The cosine of the angle 40 degrees is 0.77. Here, a larger angle will have a smaller cosine. For a general angle, theta, cosine theta is always the central displacement. the usual abbreviation, cos theta. The initial line, the unit circle, the tangent at the point 1 on the initial line, graph paper. In this sequence, we shall describe each angle by that part of the tangent line cut off by the angle. The tangent of the angle 40 degrees is 0.84. We can think of the tangent of an angle as the sideways projection of part of the sloping line. Here, the larger the angle, the larger the tangent. A general angle, theta. And the usual abbreviation, tan theta.